Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to introduce today's fight of the evening. In the red corner, weighing in at 154.4 pounds, fighting out of Hustle, Damian McJack!
Czyli na świecie, to dla matka dzieciaka ze starzec przy mnie kobiecie. Jak słońce leci, co mi dać, tu życie chwa. Na świecie jest to nasza osobista męka. Wizja jak lekam, żeby mała białej sukni. Za nasze zdrowie ziomy wilki, kierunkiem się stuknij. Życie jest piękne, spokoju szczerze pragnie. Może kiedyś, bo na razie tu żyje w bagnie. Choć już nie pragnę, co dzień pracuję ciężko. Ale nie doszedłem do celu, chodziłem własną ścieżką. To nie jest łatwe, żyć w pustojemu tutaj. Gdy traktuję cię z bruta, to ciągle żyję z podkreską. Gdzie to nie jest?
In the blue corner, weighing in at 153 pounds, fighting out of Blackburn Predators, Aaron McDonald!
We have Aaron McDonald versus Damian McJack. This is the 13th fight of the night, 70 kilo fight, amateur A class. This is going to be a fantastic bout.
Yeah, it's going to be brilliant. If you look up Aaron McDonald's name, it just says Beast.
Although Makisak isn't exactly small either, is he?
No, not at all, but I mean, the way Aaron trains, he trains all the time.
Trains with good guys as well, you know. He's aggressive as well, aggressive.
He's very, very aggressive. He's very aggressive in the gym, so when he fights, it's doubled. If not trebled. Aaron looking for a big lift takedown there. Big slam there by Aaron.
He's a genuinely tough kid as well, you know. You get a lot of lads who, you know, he's big and strong, but this guy takes a beating.
Yeah, he'll take a dig and just, like, it doesn't even faze him. He'll just carry and walk through it sort of thing. Damien's holding on to Aaron's head here. He's kind of just stalling position. Aaron's got a nice tight crossface there from side control. Oh, sorry, it's half guard, actually.
Damien's done well to get his half guard and his close guard back here as well.
Yeah. Aaron needs to be maybe quite aware of the guillotine, but he's safe there.
Just got to watch his arms, because Damien's going to be looking to catch that right arm of Aaron's. He's already looking to lock it up. Maybe to look for spin for an arm lock. He's up against the fence though, is Damien, and it's going to be difficult to move his hips here.
Yeah, definitely. Aaron's got him pinned there. Aaron just needs to be a bit more aware of where his hand position is. Maybe look to put his hands on the body, not have it on the mat.
Yeah, it's dangerous having your hands on the mat. Obviously, you can get overhooked.
Yeah, the opponent can start looking to set up a triangle and stuff like that. Damien's done well to recover guard here. But Aaron's just letting him feel his strength and let him feel the pressure.
Yeah, both well-matched fighters here.
Damien, Mac Jack, fights out of Hustle MMA. Which is quite funny, because Aaron is actually a hustler, so works out quite well. Aaron's done something very smart there, and quite subtly, he's moved him over into his own corner, so he's got the corner advice of Gavin Boardman and Andy Miles.
Yeah, he's listening intently as well.
Yeah.
Just staying safe, not letting him attack the arms.
Dean Weir might be looking to stand the fight up here if not much goes on.
I think he will, yeah. This will be... interesting to see what happens on the feet as well.
I think he's smart of Aaron this, because he don't want to get too confident and start unloading shots and then leave himself in a submission. So staying safe is the most important thing. If you can land shots and they're there, then great, take them. But don't go crazy and get caught in a submission doing so.
Yeah, he's doing well here. He's got the takedown and he's stifling what Mac Jack's trying to do.
Yeah, that's it. And that'll score high on the judges. He's pinning him and he's not letting him do anything
as well. He's landing shots.
Yeah, he is. Yeah,
big shot there as well. Yeah. Oh, big shot.
Big shots to the head as well. And as we said before, Aaron is very strong, so you won't want to take a shot of him. Even what looks like a light shot would be a heavy shot.
Oh, he's a powerful, powerful guy as well. That's a 10-second clacker there. And obviously the corner team are getting ready to go in. And, that's a professional corner team there. They've already left with 10 seconds left, ready to jump straight in. Wasting no time.
They're in there first. Aaron's bouncing around still, like the fight's not even started. Looks very, very fit. In great shape, isn't he, Javi, there? He's hardly even breathing, heavy. See how long it took for his corner team to get in the cage, then?
Yeah, that's like, 20 seconds gone now.
Yeah, he's not had any water yet or anything. One thing I've actually noticed about Aaron when he spars and stuff like that, he'll throw. It's a southpaw, so when he throws his big left hand, if you cover it and you on a normal opponent, say you'd cover it and you wouldn't feel any effect. But when Aaron hits you, he knocks you back about 10 feet. So even though you've kind of blocked it, it still like knocks you flying. So it's like you've still been hit with a big, big shot.
Yeah, that you get born with that kind of explosive power. You can't build that.
No, that's it. That natural just.
Yeah, it can hit you on the shoulder and knock you out.
Natural explosive power. And even if it doesn't knock you out, it scores high in the judges because they see their opponent go flying.
Yeah.
I wonder what Damien Mad Jack's going to do here.
It's an interesting clash as well. It's a southpaw versus orthodox. Aaron Scores is coming out of the southpaw stance. Nice low kick there. Heavy, heavy rear kick.
Oh. You see what he did then? He threw one low and then he went again but threw the second one to the head.
Yeah, it upsets the opponent, doesn't it?
He keeps him guessing, doesn't he? He doesn't know where he's gonna throw next.
That's it.
I really want to see Aaron unload that left hand of his.
He's waiting.
Really load it.
He's waiting there. As soon as he steps in now, he's gonna throw it.
Yeah, I think he's gonna come forward with a big throw. Right. Boom, there it was.
And
boom,
again.
Boom, and again, yeah. Don't want to be getting caught with too many of them.
Aaron's got a good body lock here.
Yeah, he has.
He's on the back.
Not quite yet, though. Now he's up on top. Looks to be in top half guard, I think. Or is it side control?
Oh.
It's mount now. It was side control, now it's mount.
Just got to make sure it doesn't get bridged now. He's got to stay heavy.
Sorry, no, obviously. As he's jumped a mount, he's actually landed in half guard on the other leg.
And Max Jack's obviously wanting to get onto his side, isn't he?
He's actually caught Damien there. I can't see where he's caught. It looks like his ear, but I can't tell. It's definitely blood from somewhere anyway.
Yeah. Mac Jack wants to get onto his side and start working for that underhook. Obviously, Aaron wants to keep him against the cage,
keep him pinned and just stifle him.
Yeah. He's got his guard back, but it's hard to use, isn't it? Get the full guard against the cage.
It is, yeah. It really is.
He'd probably be better off in half guard.
Aaron is very wary of the submissions attempts that Damien's going to throw up from here. So he doesn't want to get caught with anything, so he's just staying safe and unloading when he can. I think the cut is actually on Aaron.
Nice big shot there from McDonald. Come on, Damien! It looks that way, doesn't it? It looks like McDonald's got cut on his forehead. Nice.
I'll tell you something though, Avi. If it goes the distance, in the second round at the minute, if it goes past the third round to the distance, Aaron will still be very sharp. He works very hard on his training, very hard on his conditioning alone. He's not going to get tired. He'd probably go another three rounds after this.
He's always in good shape, isn't he?
Yeah.
I think it might be blood coming from the nose of McDonald.
Yeah, I think he's got a bit of a busted nose. He won't let it affect him, though.
No, the kid's nails.
Show you that.
Mac Jack seems a bit worried, though. He seems a bit something wrong. I'm not sure what it is. But
he was looking at his wrist before. I don't know what it is. No.
McDonald's thrown twice that left hand, and he's landed it both times and hurt his opponent. He just needs to let it go.
He does, yeah. He's still feeling him out a little bit, isn't he? But he really just needs to unload. Oh, that was beautiful. That was
good.
That was really nice. It didn't land too cleanly, though. If it would have landed a bit more clean, I think it would have been a knockout. It was very, very unorthodox.
That was a flasher.
Yeah, very nice. Very good to see.
He did say he was going to throw that as well. He said before the fight that he was going to throw a spinning hook kick. Yeah.
I've seen him throw it in sparring a few times, actually. He's done one on me in the past where I've been lucky enough to just duck my head out of it.
Yeah.
Otherwise, it's me going to sleep there.
You need a new head.
Yeah.
This is a good fight here. It's the third round now, and this is really going to be the deciding round. I think that McDonald's dominated both rounds, though.
He pinned him on the ground. He's landed a few shots. He's landed some good shots standing as well, and then took him down.
Barring a submission or a knockout.
He scored points for the takedown as well.
Yeah, barring a submission or a knockout from Maczak, then I think McDonald's going to win an unanimous decision.
Definitely. He's got such good stand-up, Aaron, so it's a shame he's not really unloading.
I think he will in this round. He knows it's the third round. Nothing left to lose.
That's it. But when he has, he's hurt his opponent.
Exactly.
It's a shame he's not capitalising on it and doing it more.
What do you think Mac Jack's corner will tell him to do?
Maybe score the takedown. Like,
yeah, get on top.
Yeah, throw some shots and you get the takedown.
Aaron's raring to go, isn't he?
Yeah, that's it.
Both fighters still dangerous here in this third round, though.
Aaron's going to come straight forward with a big flurry of shots. Boom, boom, there you go. Like a young Victor Belfort there, wasn't he?
He is, isn't he?
Also southpaw as well.
He's ever so strong as well.
Yeah, he's very strong.
He's got to watch the clinch here, though. He could
get caught with a knee. I think that might have been what caught him before in the first round. Second round, sorry.
Oh, nice elbow.
Yeah, I don't think it was an elbow, actually. I think it was a left hook.
Yeah, I think it was a left hook.
Obviously, he can't throw them in this fight, so if he did land it, I don't think he would have meant to. But I thought Aaron was going to lift him then and turn him off the hips and slam him.
Mike Jack's done really well here, stifling, you know, Aaron's game when he's on top. You know, he's reduced him to holding him down and throwing pepper shots.
I thought he was going to say he's reduced him to tears then. No, yeah, you're very right.
You know, all credit to Mac Jack. You know, McDonald's a tough opponent.
I thought Aaron McDonald was going to turn and do another spinning back kick, then he's shown it.
Yeah,
then
I think he's going to throw it. I think he's going to throw it again before this fight's finished.
Yeah, perhaps. How amazing would that be to see a knockout with that? See a knockout with a spinning back kick.
I'll take my hat off and eat it.
You're not wearing a hat.
I know, but I'll buy one, put it on and eat it.
Oh! He actually got... That was a right surprise. Damien Maczak actually threw his own spinning back kick and landed. Oh, big shot there by Aaron. And he actually used the forearm and pushed him onto the fence.
Looks very uncomfy there for Damien. He's got his double underhooks here, Zarin. Mike Jack's doing a great job of keeping his weight based.
Gotta watch the guillotine here, Aranaz.
He's defending the hands well though, he's fighting,
yeah,
fighting hands.
He's still hand fighting, yeah. He looked worried for a second, but he seems okay now, but Damien's pushed him right opposite to the other end of the cage and actually put Aaron's back on the cage now, right near his own corner. This is actually Damien's strongest round so far, isn't it?
Yeah,
landing
easily.
That spinning back kick and obviously putting Aaron on the fence, but...
Aaron's got double underhooks here, he should use these. Oh, it's not double under, it's 50-50.
But Aaron still put him on the cage there, put his back in the cage.
Yeah, I mean, the way this fight's going, it's a unanimous decision for McDonald.
Yeah,
Mike Jack needs to really push the pace now.
Yeah, Mike Jack's got to do something crazy something decisive to win the fight, really. Aaron just carries on stifling him here, he's going to win.
It's a good performance here for McDonald. He's really, you know, showing a bit of maturity here, hasn't he?
Yeah, he's shown great takedowns and some great stand-up as well, some great flurries.
Yeah. A lot of maturity shown in this performance. You know, he's just... stifled his game, hasn't he? He's got on top.
Yeah, he's matured like a fine cheese, hasn't he? Got respect there.
Cracking fight.
Yeah, pretty good.
The judges have come to the unanimous decision in the blue corner. Yeah!